It's My Carolina Today with Vawanda Calloway and Alex Butler.
Hello and happy May Day.
That's right. It's the first day of May.
Yeah. Did you have May Day celebrations when you were in school?
I didn't. Honestly, when I saw this written, I was like, wait, what's May Day exactly?
Yeah. When I was in elementary school, we always had a May Day celebration. Oh. It was a field day. We'd go outside and play games. There was the sock hop and the potato sack race.
And
I grew up near Camp Lejeune Marine Corps base, and the Marines would come and they would actually be the ones in charge of our race. And, you know, little girls, fifth grade, we were like, oh my gosh, the Marines, they're so tall and handsome. Oh my, they're so strong. We just thought it was the coolest thing when the Marines came.
That's awesome.
And we'd have a maypole.
So it was like May Day to the fullest.
It was a big deal.
Okay, well, May Day, happy May Day. If you're swinging around, cool. Okay, that's awesome. Okay, so included in May, of course, we're still in spring showers. So they brought us some rainbows. And if you might have caught this, it's the double rainbow that was out yesterday. Now, I didn't see it. Did you see this?
I didn't see it live. I saw pictures of it.
Okay.
I heard lots of people talking about it last night on social media. And producer Cam took this photo from Holly Springs. I hate that I didn't see it.
I couldn't believe, like,
person.
Look how big it is.
Yeah.
I'm like, it's unbelievable. And I saw somebody else had one of, like, the full, like, a double, like, just, like, it was huge, like, just beautiful with the colors. Alyssa Corfrent, or Weather at WNCN, she had one posted that was just unbelievable. So really cool stuff. That's, I think, the best part of the rain. I hate when it rains, but I love when we get a double rainbow out of it.
And it's nice that we got that reward because it was scary. There was hail.
Oh my gosh.
Lila was, you know, jumping because it was
terrible. Do you know, I was at the mall and they were about to shut the mall down. Yes, because I guess there's a basin of water.
Oh, the flooding. Yeah,
it
always
floods.
Oh,
my. I was like, what's happening? It was pandemonium. People were running around. I was like, oh, my gosh, we got to go. Ooh. And so I didn't know. I had no idea that that's what happens. I was like, wait a second. So anyway, it was
but
pretty funny.
It didn't.
No, everything was fine. Everybody was okay. But in the beginning, I was like, wait, what's happening? Pandemonium. Mm-hmm. But it turned out to be all right. And it was all fun and games. Everybody in the mall was having a good time. We were enjoying ourselves together.
Okay, yeah, just FYI, Crabtree Valley.
Yes. I didn't know.
It floods sometimes.
I didn't
but thank
know.
Goodness it didn't.
I know. They told me that I needed to move my car up to the second floor. They were like, ladies and gentlemen, please move your vehicles to the second level.
Ooh.
I was like, okay, gots to go.
Okay.
Peace. Okay. Anyways.
Tomorrow is opening day for the Western Wake Farmers Market at its second location, UNC Wellness Center in Cary. They'll be open every Saturday through Thanksgiving. And this is a lovely gift basket that they sent us over with some of the wonderful goodies that you can purchase at the original Western Wake Farmers Market or this new location that is opening tomorrow. So doesn't it look so fresh?
Oh my gosh.
So beautiful.
So festive.
We have some samples of some of the things. We have organic strawberries.
Okay. Loving the strawberries. Oh, I even heard the little crunch in there and you bit into it. What's
so
this
sweet.
Here?
That is a Parmesan fennel
breadstick
from Great Harvest Bread. I'm double this nut.
Good flavors.
That is good.
I like that. And then we've got cheese from where?
We have Old Glencoe Piedmont Farm. Oh, God, I've got three things in my
hand. Yeah, okay.
Old Glencoe Piedmont Farm out of Burlington.
I like the cheese. That's good. Very rich.
Delicious. So creamy and smooth.
Yeah, like that's what I meant. Maybe I meant creamy. That
it's
was
rich, too.
And rich.
It's great. So check out the Western Wake Farmers Market or the Farmers Market near you. Now is the time.
Okay.
All right, so my iPhone is spying on me.
Yes. Okay, so here's what happened. Last night, I'm on my phone, and I'm looking through it, and I see somebody posted this little thing about how you don't know that your iPhone knows everything you're doing all the time. So here's what I want you to do. We're going to walk you through it, because you might not realize it, but your iPhone's been recording exactly where you've been and how long you spent there. And maybe this is common knowledge, but I had no idea this was in your phone. So here you go. If you've got an iPhone, pull it out. To access frequent locations, here's what you do. Open your iPhone settings. Go to menu, you know, obviously, select privacy, then location services, then scroll all the way down to system services, and in system services, scroll all the way down to the bottom, and you'll press frequent locations, and you can look at the history section there, and it is just an overload of every single place you've been pinpointed on a map, including how long you've been there. Time distances. So like if you today left work at 4, it will say you were at work from 9:30 to 4. And then it will say that you went home from 5:30 to whatever time. And if you stopped at a gas station, it'll have that pinpointed on the map too. People about to get caught in some crazy things.
Okay, this is a lot of information that makes me nervous.
I know.
But my question is, can this be accessed by anyone other than me if they don't have my phone?
See, that's the question, because remember with the iCloud pictures and how those got out?
I don't use the cloud.
I don't use the cloud either.
At all.
But now, yeah.
This cheese is good.
But anyway, so now you know. If it wasn't something you knew, now I ain't told you about it. And if you want to find that, you can Google online.
This is a great way for couples to keep track of each other.
Right? Just saying.
I mean, you know, it's not, like GPS. Not that I'm endorsing that, but.
It's true. GPS in your phone. There you go.
The selfie arm. Have you heard of this?
If you're doing something else with your iPhone besides stalking.
It's a fiberglass arm you can use to take photos of yourself. Basically, it's a selfie stick with fingers and skin that is the color of a corpse.
Yes, oh my God,
a corpse.
Look at that thing. It's terrible.
The artist behind it only plans to make 10. It'll sell for $6,200. It's a sarcastic commentary on our need to constantly let the internet know that we exist.
Oh my gosh.
Just a prototype for now.
If somebody pays $6,000 for that.
I think they're just doing it just to say, you're dumb if
for
you
giggles.
Buy this. And if you buy this, you are a really sad human being.
I just can't imagine that that's where the world has gone. But anyway, it is.